I blame a lot of the economy falling apart on Oprah. Because she ordered American women to go out and buy things they could not afford. That's when I quit watching the show. The dichotomy in her shows was so ridiculous. On Tuesday, she'd come out and go, ladies, it's all about Jimmy Choo's shoes. You gotta have them. You need them. Your feet are gonna fall off. You're gonna have bunions the size of Montana if you don't get some Jimmy Choo's shoes. Now, if you've never heard of them, they're about $500 or more a pair. Highly impractical. Then the following day, the entire show would be about credit card debt. And there's all these 40-somethings crying on the stage. And she's just berating them. Ladies, how did it get this out of hand? They're like, you fucking told us. Why don't we rewind the tape, Chubby Chubstein? I will believe it was you who brought Mr. Choo into the conversation. If I watch Oprah now, I only like to watch it when it's a hard, serious, depressing topic, because she has had so many giveaway shows in the past when it's a hard, serious, depressing topic. When they pan the audience, you can see the look of sheer disappointment on those women's faces. Oprah comes out. Today's topic is abused women in India. Pan the crowd. What the fuck? Where are my free hug boots, bitch? I stood outside for 5 hours. There's some 900-year-old lady from Wisconsin. Does this mean we're not getting a free Pontiac? I kind of went over the edge, too, with Oprah because of the magazine. Because she puts herself on the cover every single month. I'm like, could you be more narcissistic? How do you bring that up at the staff meeting without totally sounding like Hitler? Yeah, as far as the cover was gone, the ideas that I keep coming up with, they are of me. Every single month we will have a photograph of me. Sometimes I will be holding a basket of puppies for no reason. Sometimes I will be painting a picture of me. I didn't think you could get more narcissistic than that. Oh, yes, you can. A few months ago, Oprah had 2 pictures of herself on the front. Wow, because she's fat again. So she had a picture of her now, the super chubby Oprah, and then a picture of the less chubby Oprah from before. And then within the article, she just says, you know, she thinks it's inexcusable. Finally, something we agree upon, Oprah. Yes, it is inexcusable because you are a billionaire. I understand why poor people are fat, because they're poor and Taco Bell is goddamn delicious. Taco Bell will throw things into your car for 59 cents you've never tasted anything like before in your life. You're like, the Gorlata what? Oh my God, drive around again before they cancel this. This is awesome. Get 100. I don't want to brag, but I have $8. Get 100. I really believe Taco Bell should be awarded restaurant of the century. They have 5 ingredients, and every month they trick me back in there with something new and crazy. Kathleen, have you had the black taco? No. I'm coming. Okay, so I get why poor people are fat. But Oprah, you're a billionaire. You have enough money to pay a man to stand there and literally slap shit out of your hand before you put it in your mouth. You could hire a full-time food slapper. You're so rich, you could pay someone to exercise you. You could just lay there like a baby with cerebral palsy and have people move your legs. Oh, hey, oh, hey. And then Oprah sold out. I never thought I'd see what happened because her ratings were not that great, and she booked Sarah Palin as a guest. Really? Oh, I think we all know Oprah's politics. To book Sarah Palin, wow. And I can't listen to Sarah Palin because I can't listen to any full-grown adult that fake cusses. Either cuss or do not. But that weird middle ground, I just find extremely creepy. Well, golly gee, donut holes, whiz-bang cheese crackers, America. And she always says, gee, America, I just can't believe I'm here. I'm sitting at home going, fucking neither can I, ma'am. I really can't believe you're here either. Christ, I'm 40. I have glasses. Was there some sort of contest that I didn't know I could enter to be John McCain's running mate? And she would continuously brag, well, I'm the governor of Alaska. Ma'am, I've been there 10 times. Not a big deal. You know why? There's no people there, ma'am. There are more reindeer than people in the state of Alaska. You can Google that. I would have been more impressed had she said she was the game warden. Wow, that is intense. There's like grizzly bears up there, and those moose get into town and kick old people, and you're not allowed to shoot them. You got to trick them out with apples. There is a lot going on. And she loves the Tea Party people. I don't understand the Tea Party women that are walking around signs going, we want what the founding fathers wanted. Well, ladies, they didn't let us vote. So you might want to reread the brochure of the team you just signed up with. Wow. I'll give it to the Tea Party people, though. They're active. They are out marching and doing. And I think, God, I cannot think of one thing. I've never been in a protest. I don't really even get them. I might be in one if it like started in my apartment. I'd be like, yeah, fuck, Mike's right. I'm on Mike's side. I'm done. And then I thought, what would I get up for? I couldn't. I'm like, maybe if they said we're going to ban alcohol again, I'd be like, all right, fuck, I got to go. Where's the meeting? I got to get up. I got to go somewhere.